Hello friends, I'm Chef Umesh from Chitkara School of Hospitality, and today we are going to read about salads and salad dressing. Before moving ahead, as we have already read about vegetables and fruit cookery in our previous chapters, now we are going to learn about the uses of different vegetables and fruits and some other ingredients in our salad making or salad cookery chapter. Before that, we move, I must know that what is a salad, which is also known as salade, salad, insalata, salada, or salad in different languages. As per the books, salad is defined as a ready-to-eat food with a mix of small pieces of raw vegetables or fruits or other ingredients. It is generally served cold and it is served with a dressing. The food can be a cold dish or green vegetables or mix of fruits or a hot mixture of hot pecan food or frozen mixture of plant fruits or chopped food in hot aspic, coleslaw, potato or meat are the examples which have been also briefed in Theory of Cookery books by Krishna Arora. In general, salads are cold preparation made from raw, cooked or plant vegetables singly or in combination, and can include other items such as fresh herbs, fruits, nuts and cooked eggs, pasta, rice, fish, meat and poultry. A salad can be served in various different courses such as salad course. In a very formal meal experience, salads are sometimes served after a main course. Such salads are light and refreshing in nature and provide a change from heavy main course. Well-dressed salad greens and savory vegetables are a popular choice. Main course, it is substantial enough as a main dish. One of the bodybuilding foods such as meat, fish, eggs or cheese can also be used as a base of a salad. The volume and richness of these salads are adequate to satisfy a normal appetite. Salad can also be served as an accompaniment in some cases. The salad is also served in main course, can be kept into an accompaniment dish or served as accompaniment in smaller portions. If we are going towards salad classification, it can be classified into two major categories, that is a simple salad or a compound salad. Later on, compound salad are subdivided into four major categories. Defining a simple salad, it can be a green salad or salad in season. These are the two distinct classification of a simple or plain salad. As the name suggests, these are simple or are prepared with a single vegetable or a single ingredients with a dressing. These salads are served raw or cooked. Such salads normally use only a single kind of vegetable as a base and only one of the two ingredients in small quantity as decoration or garnish. There are some examples of simple salads with their appropriate dressings. For example, if we are using a cabbage as our simple salad or to prepare a simple salad, we can julienne it and serve it with vinaigrette or mustard cream. Similarly, a tomato salad can be cut into slices and can be served with chopped parsley and vinegar. Vinegar is a dressing about which we will read in our next slides. Moving on to compound salads. These can be classified into four major categories, which is a compound salad can be of vegetable based, fruit based, fish based or seafood based, and the last one, poultry, game or meat based salad. A salad can be subdivided in four parts, that is a base. A base may be made up of lettuce, cabbage or any other leafy vegetables. It must cover the bottom part of the salad. The leaf must be clean and thoroughly washed because they may contain a lot of soil and insects. Preferably, all the salad's leaves must be washed with chlorine solution. Some of the examples of salad leaves which are used in salad making are arugula, Belgian endive, cress, iceberg, red lettuce, doloroso, radicchio, etc. Then comes the body of a salad. As the name suggests, body comprises of the main ingredient of the salad, on which the name of the salad can be kept. It must be proportional to the base. The body must comprise of a main ingredient and of a small bite-sized pieces of the ingredients. The ingredients used should have a balance of flavors and taste. Then comes garnish. The main purpose of garnish is to add eye appeal to the finished product, but a certain number of times it can be added to improve the taste of the salad. Garnish can be either a part of the body also. It should be kept simple. Some of the most widely used garnishes or the garnish leaves are coriander sprig, basil, parsley, cherry tomato, etc. In the end, to mix the salad and to give it a piquant taste or a savory taste, dressings are used. They can be of different ingredients and can be prepared in different ways. A dressing is served with salads. It is used to flavor the salad, provides food value, and improves palatability and appearance. Dressing may be in liquid or semi-liquid form. It can be made with a variety of ingredients ranging from oil, vinegar, cream, yogurt, eggs, and cheese. There are certain or different oils which are used for making different dressings. They can be olive oil, walnut oil, salad oil, groundnut oil, sesame oil, and grapeseed oil, etc. As we have learned that with major simple salads, we usually use vinegar as dressing. So vinegar is usually a mixture of vinegar with oil so that an emulsion can be prepared. Usually vinegar is defined as a salad dressing or a mixture of oils and acids such as vinegar or citrus juice. The standard ratio used in a vinegar is 3:1. Vinaigrette consists of 3 parts of oil and 1 part of vinegar or citrus fruit juice mixed into a stable emulsion. There are different types of vinaigrettes like French dressing, which uses 3 parts of oil with mustard and garlic paste. English dressing, which uses 1 part of oil and 2 parts of vinegar. English mustard and seasoning are also used in this vinaigrette. Then there is another famous in vinegar, which is American vinegar, which contains equal quantities of vinegar and oil. Mustard and seasoning are also added in this. And with the last slide, we are ending our today's topic, that is salads and salad dressing. For any queries, you may reach out to me at umesh.chukra@chitkara.edu.in. Thank you.